There are several farms, over 300 acres, and the management practices of the different farms vary. But for this farm, we've decided to go to agroecological farming.
We definitely are pursuing being organic. It's better for the environment, it's better for your body.
So what you would see here is meeting the challenges of climate change through organic practices. Re-engineering the farm using the permaculture design and agroecological farming with organic farming. So we're mixing it all up. We try to control runoff and soil water. So what we have done is to include swales, mini swales. It's really a level drain along the contour that holds water for a particular period of time. It really captures the water and feeds the substrate. In the dry season or when it becomes very hot, below you have water. So the plants can stand up much longer to drought than if we didn't have these swales. We have windbreaks right around, and within the windbreaks we have crops.
We do intercropping.
And plant stacking. Stacking is a form of intercropping. Plant stacking really means that you have different levels of plant until you reach the ground. When the rain falls, the rain can hardly get to this directly to the soil. Protected agriculture, we try to protect the soil and have as many crops as possible. We are experimenting on mini protective structure. So what we have done is to build some umbrellas, I call them. We cover the soil with it about 3 feet from the ground. The rain falls on the plastic, does not go to the crop, falls into the drains on both sides, right, that we use as mini swale, and we have crops growing, right, protected from the rain on those mini protective structures.
We do mulching.
Come in with a weed eater and we will cut the weeds, and the weeds will form a mulch. Again, that will cover the ground. So the ground or the soil here is always covered.
The mulching is very important because then it keeps the weeds down. Weeds are, you know, there's endless amount of weeds. So the mulching not only helps the soil, but it also helps with keeping the weeds down, controlling the weeds. And we've actually started using cardboard too. I try to collect the cardboard from some of our stores that sell some of our products. We put down the cardboard and then put the grass on top of that, and that really does help controlling the weeds. As a member of GOAM, the organic movement, that's the hope, is to try to get as many farmers to be organic as possible.
To think organic and to bring the system organic.
When they see the results and that it will be cost effective going that way, I think it's a no-brainer that's what we should be doing. And in the long term it will be cheaper because we'll be self-sufficient, and that's part of one of our goals, is to be self-sufficient where we wouldn't have to be buying anything.
First and most important lesson is that organic farming can work. And organic farming, unlike what most people believe, you know, that production would fall and you would not be able to make a profit, I am not seeing that.